Hey everybody, today I'm going to be doing the July horror block. I'm sorry I have been missing with my horror blocks, but I want people's opinions on who watched this. Now, when I get my horror block, it is literally about 2 weeks after the US gets it. Is there any point in me doing these videos? Do you want me to still do them? Do you want to see what I've got, see my reactions to the products? Because is that what it's about? Or some people tend to watch the box just to see these videos to see what's in the box. I'm not really sure. So I'd love a little bit of feedback down below about what you think. I just enjoy sharing the items. I did film last month's, but the footage was not very good. So I ended up kind of getting rid of it. Then I wasn't well, then I was busy. So unfortunately last month's, I just didn't manage to get the video up. But I wanted to do this one because I am really excited about this box. It's really amazing. The thing I do want to address is I do think they need to change their shipping. Here in the UK, by the time DHL gets it to us, it is literally, I mean, they forgot to, they actually think, I think, don't quote me, but I think they forgot to post mine because I contacted them and mine didn't actually get posted out till August the 3rd. And they always post in the last couple of days of the calendar month that the box is for. So, and I contacted them and said, hey, there's no tracking on here. They're like, oh yes, okay, so here's your tracking, it's just gone out today. And I was like, I might not have got that box if I hadn't made that contact. So their customer services, I've not had good experience with customer services because I didn't get the May block and it just took forever. And they were like, oh, just wait a bit longer, wait a bit longer. And I was like, you waited a whole month, You know, it's just, I wasn't too impressed with their overall customer services. So I've been quite disappointed about that. And the other thing that I do want to raise, other than the shipping, no, we'll go back to the shipping, I'd like them to ship 5 days before they ship to the US customers, because it takes us 14 days to get it here. So if, at least if they ship 5 days before, then at least we're getting it, say, a week after the other people rather than 2 weeks after. Because I watch people who do these videos and I can't watch those videos until I get mine, because I like it to be surprised when I've got my box. So it's just, it's a bit of a pain that we have to wait so long after. And I don't think it would be that much harmful to them to post earlier. So to have an international cutoff date for subscription and then US, that would be great. The other thing I think they need to take into consideration is Blu-rays. I have a multi-region DVD player, so when they send a DVD, no problem, it will play it. But I've got 3 Blu-rays now that will not work because they are not, I don't have a multi-region Blu-ray. And they're for the US and I'm in the UK. Now, I can't be the only person that is having this problem, but I do think that they need to address it. To be honest, if they just sent me a DVD, I wouldn't feel cheated. I wouldn't think, oh, but the US got a Blu-ray. I don't care as long as I can watch it. So I'd rather they just sent Blu-rays, DVDs to the UK and internationally so that we know that we can watch it, because I can't watch Blu-rays. Not all of them play. Some of them do, not all of them do. I wasn't able to watch Deathgasm. And then I can't remember what the other two were, but I couldn't watch the latest one that we got. What was the last one about that kid? I can't remember what it was called, but I couldn't watch it. And then there was another one that I got and I was like, I can't watch that one. It's just a bit of a nightmare. So anyway, there's a Blu-ray in here. I haven't tried it yet, so we'll see. But I will be complaining to them if this one won't work, because it's no good getting an item in a box that is absolutely no use. And it's not even as if I can sell it on either. So, you know, it's a bit disappointing. So rant over, we'll get into what's in the box. It's really, really nice box this month. I do wish we had more horror block exclusives. I know I'm pretty much on my own there, but I like the horror block exclusives because I like to decorate my room with them. And I just like that it's something different that is not worldwide available. So I think that's quite nice. It's nice to get unique items in these boxes. So anyway, I'm going to talk about the Blu-ray first. So apparently there were a selection of Blu-rays that you could get. And I got this one called Kill Katie Malone. And I've never heard of this actually. Dean Cain's in it. I know who he is. The next item we got in a box is kind of a playset thing, which I actually made it up. So I can actually show you. It's a bit like Blue Peter. Here's one I made earlier. But it's a Walking Dead toy. It's got 109 pieces, so it's absolutely huge, really. Like, not huge, but like there's so much work to go into it, a huge amount of effort to make it. And it is an upper prison cell, obviously from when they were living in the prison. And it says you can stack them and build them, and you can actually make like a whole prison block with a walkway and the stairs and everything. It's like, it's pretty amazing. There's a watchtower and then there's vehicles as well, so you connect it all together and stuff. That's what it looks like. And it looks like in this one you either get the zombie or you get one of the cast, and I actually got Carol, so I was excited about that. But it did take some putting together. There were a couple of parts that were missing, but luckily I still managed to get it together, and there was an extra part that I didn't need. So I'm going to show you it. I've actually got it on display in the room, because I think it's kind of cool once you get it together. Oh, my table's over. Can't have that now. So this is the prison cell. I'm going to take that off. So you've got this little table, and on here, I'm not really sure what that little box is, but you have got a gun on top of a book there on your little table. There's also a little knife, which I've actually got in the toilet. The places on this are really, really small, so you kind of don't want to lose them. See, I can't even show you properly. That's the little knife. And then it's got a toilet and a sink in there, and then it's got your bed. Now the blanket doesn't seem to fit on properly, so I've just put it under the bed, and then you've got like a mattress, a duvet, and then a pillow. It's super detailed. The floor is really, really nice. It's kind of all stone, and it's got like little lumps, cracks and stuff in it. And then you've got the door, which actually opens and closes. It's really, really quite cool. So yeah, I really like it. And then it's got this little walkway on the outside, and like I said, I got Carol and I just kind of fitted her on there, so she's just standing outside on the railings. She's got very bored knees though. It's a bit unusual, but it's a really nice little set, and like I said, it's beautifully made. I really like the effect of the stone on the actual Lego pieces. That's what they technically really are. Yeah, and it's got like all the little things to kind of fix it on. So I've just got this displayed and I like it. I think it's kind of cute, and I love The Walking Dead, so it's quite nice to have that on display. So that's what that looks like. And they retail for around £18 in the UK, because I found one online for around £18-19, so they're not cheap. Yeah. Right, so the next item. Well, we always get Room Mob in the box, which is a great magazine. Tells you what's coming, lots of features and articles and things, and it's really, really a great read. So I do love getting Room Morgue. I need to go through because I want to cut some pictures out of some of them. Just ones where it's kind of adverts on the back of adverts. I don't want to cut articles out and stuff, because I do keep these and I really like them. So you get that. And then we got a picture. I think it's kind of a homage to The Night of the Living Dead, but this is the Simpsons Treehouse of Horror item. And Bart's at the front spraying onto the gravestone, "I will call more paramedics." And then you've got Lisa in the background, and I think that's Maggie. And you've got, I think that's Mr. Burns over here. It looks like him. But Homer and Marge are there. Homer has got like a Mohican. Sorry, I'm not flipping the finger at you there. He's got a Mohican. And they're kind of very skeletal. But she's got great boobs in this. But it's really nice. So it's printed in Canada. I'll get the card. Our card obviously tells you exactly what you've got in this box. And in this box we get 6 items, which is really, really great value. Right. So it just says that no TV and no beer make Homer something something. I can't read that. Makes Homer something something. Reminisce about your favourite Simpsons Treehouse of Horror episodes of this exclusive art print, quoth the Raven, nevermore. That's actually really cool. I'm going to frame that up and put that in this room. I have got space up on the wall up there. I'm actually working on a piece of art myself to go up there, but I still will frame this up and put this somewhere in this room, because I really love, I like The Simpsons, watched it for years, but the Treehouse of Horror episodes are most definitely my favourite. I think they are always, always amazing. So I'm quite excited to have something. It's something a little bit different for the box as well, not to have like your standard kind of genres in there. So I really like that. The Blu-ray, it looks like you could get the Amityville Haunting, Abraham Lincoln versus Zombies. There looks like there's a triple feature one there. that has got in Forget Me Not. I can see that, and I can't see what the other ones say. Then you've got this one. There's another triple feature. And then you can't, I think there's one that says Zombie Night. You can't really kind of read all the titles on there, but you could have got any. So I'm glad that I got one that I haven't seen. And then The Walking Dead buildable. The walkers are coming. Are you prepared? Well, now you can build your own scene from The Walking Dead with the amazing buildable set. Create, stack, and add however you'd like. Defend your base from the horde. So that's quite good. And then we've got the t-shirt and the last item. Now I'm saving this item. A lot of people normally do the t-shirt last, but this item is amazing. So I'm going to save that item to last and show you the t-shirt now. So the t-shirt is glow in the dark, and I love that they do these t-shirts where you can't, how to put it, it's not like a movie kind of t-shirt where it has to say what it is. I like that it's just an image, and if you're a fan, you'll know what it is. So I really like that, and I love it. We've got another black one this month, and that is the t-shirt. Like I said, it glows in the dark. I like it doesn't have that green cast. A lot of old stuff that glows in the dark tended to have that kind of green cast. And does anybody recognise that? It is the house from Psycho. The Bates Motel house. Not Bates Motel, but the Bates Motel house. So about the t-shirt, it says, duality at the Bates Motel is a serious problem, at least with this exclusive shirt from shirtpunch.com. Everyone will know exactly what side you chose. Want to see more? Visit Shirt Punch. Shirt Punch is obviously the people they use for their t-shirts. But it's so nice. I really like it. I like that it's just this kind of spooky house. And not everybody will get what that is, but yeah, I like it. So I think that's really nice and really quite a unique item. So there's that. Our card in here does say that next month's Horror Block will feature an exclusive item from Supernatural. Not bothered about that. I'm not a Supernatural fan. But we do get four exclusive in the next box, which is a very exciting, and we also get an item from Ghostbusters, which I like. Now the other thing you get is, and it's behind me, I haven't got it to kind of reach, but every month you do get a $10 credit at Shirt Punch, which is amazing. I registered with them. Once you register with them, they actually give you a $10 credit as well, and you earn points on every purchase. I'm very excited because there's a couple of shirts on there I've already got my eye on, and I'm probably going to place an order quite soon. You can save all the cards up and get a $100 credit, or you can actually, like, they'll do 10 and that's your $100, or you can just use them as you get them. So yeah, I think that's really great because this box is amazing anyway. By the time you get the box, a small item in your t-shirt is the box paid for, and then you've got all your other stuff, and then you get $10 credit with Shirt Punch. It's amazing value. Right, the last item. So this is an exclusive, and it says, maybe if Jason Voorhees was a little more stylish, people wouldn't scream at the sight of him. At least you won't have that issue when you're rocking this exclusive Friday the 13th baseball hat. Now this hat is so amazing. I was so excited when I saw it. How beautiful. I love that it's not black. It's not got blood on it. It's just, it's amazing. It just looks, yeah, it's like you're a camper. No, it's like you're like one of the staff at Camp Crystal Lake. And you've got this nice hat to commemorate it, if you survived, that is. But it's got the mesh on the top, which is really nice for the hot weather. On the front of it, you've got the Welcome to Camp Crystal Lake sign, which is really nice. Obviously, it's the licensed version. Then it's a picture, and on it, you can see the cabin, and you can actually see Jason stood there. So it's actually got like a kind of a print of a scene on there as well. It's grey. And then underneath on the brim, it says Jason Lives with the blood dripping, which is just so cool. Oh, I'm such a nerd for this hat. It's got the tag on there. And then I love this. It's got this amazing little metal badge on the side. Now we did get a pin badge that looks exactly like that, but I love this detail on the hat. And it's amazing. Now my hair's not really kind of sorted for this hat, but that is what it looks like on. I'm gonna wear this with my Camp Crystal Lake t-shirt that I already have from a previous Horror Block, the brown one, and it's got like the crossed oars and the boat. Yes, more Friday the 13th items, please. I love Friday the 13th. I want to see a Halloween item in. We haven't had anything, and I really, really love Halloween. Oi! Shush! Well, Pup's sitting at the minute, and she's just standing there whimpering for attention. She loves to be stroked. Right, so, what do you think? I so love this hat. I'm so excited. This hat just totally makes this box for me because I love unique things like this. And I knew we were getting a hat because I knew somebody else had got it. I didn't know what it was going to look like, so I thought we were just going to get a standard beanie sort of hat. When I saw that this was a baseball cap and I saw the colour and the design, it's just kind of not what you would think of your standard horror. You expect black and blood and stuff like that. And I really love that it's not like what you would expect. And I think it's really cute. I love the colours. I think these colours will just go with anything that you're wearing as well, which, you know, as a girl, that is important. As a guy, some of you might think that's important. Not everybody does. But I just think this hat will just look amazing on everybody. And I love it. So, and I could see that Jason lives under there. Not that anybody else will be able to see that, but still. I know it's there. And I'm super happy with it. So, there you go. That is this month's horror block. So I've got a toy, technically not, but I have got a nice item to display. Huge Walking Dead fan, very excited. A Blu-ray that I hopefully can watch because I've not seen it before. I am a Psycho fan and a Bates Motel fan, and I love the t-shirt. Rue Morgue, of course, which is great. And I love the Simpsons print. What an amazing box this is. Now, I think this year they have been totally amazing from the get-go. I've loved every box. They've not done a single thing wrong for me this year, and I've been super excited to get my boxes and share them with you. So, let me know what you think. I think I'll still continue to do these videos because I do love sharing these things with you. I get very excited about it. And I know I do have people follow me on here who also love horror things, so I think it's really great to share them. And Horror Blocks, a great box. Really amazing. I highly recommend it. The value of this box is just fantastic. It's around £20, I think. But for your £20, I mean, a t-shirt like this, the quality is so amazing. They wash beautifully. I've never had a problem. It's really nice and soft, and it just is unique. You couldn't buy that anywhere. So the t-shirt's worth around, I'd say, you could go to HMV and buy something similar for £15. Not a similar design, but like the quality. So you're looking at £15 with your t-shirt already. The Rue Morgue would make up the rest of the price because I think this is a $10 magazine. It's not cheap. So everything else is a bonus after that. So, yeah. And I will be wearing this hat. I will probably display it as well. I think Ghostface might have to wear it in this room. But I'm definitely going to be wearing this hat because I absolutely love it. Yay! So I can't wait for next month's box now. Of course, we'll share it with you on this channel. I hope you've enjoyed this video as always. Don't forget to like, share, comment and subscribe. And I'm gonna love and leave you and see you in the next video. So until then, sweet dreams. Bye.